Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. So one of the things I like to do is store my videos not in my Photos library, but just in the Finder. Let me show you how you can do that and organize your videos too. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. I don't like to have my videos stored in my Photos library. I like to leave that just for photos. For one thing, it reduces the size of the photo library, and that's especially important if you're using iCloud photos, where large videos can easily take up a lot of space and take a long time to sync across your devices. I always know whether I'm looking for a photo or a video, so it's easy for me to go and look in my videos folder in the Finder for the videos I want and know that all my photos are in the Photos library. I don't take that many videos, but if I did, it would be even better because I could store those videos on an external drive and not take up a ton of space on my internal drive. But just because you have your videos stored in a folder in the Finder doesn't mean it's hard to organize them. There are a ton of tools the Finder offers to allow you to organize, easily find your videos. So here's an example of what I'm talking about. In my Documents folder, I've got a folder called Videos. And in there, I've got a bunch of different videos. Now, I don't have to just store this in my Documents folder. That's where I have it here as an example. I could decide I want the Videos folder to be at the main iCloud drive level. So now I've got a Videos folder in my iCloud drive that lives next to my Documents and Desktop folder. That's a great place for it as well. This will, of course, sync it across to my other devices and make it available on my iOS devices, which is great. But if my videos are taking up a lot of space, I may not want to have it there either. I can store it locally just on the hard drive for this one Mac by going to my Home folder. Now, there's already a folder in my Home folder called Movies. In there, I'm going to find things like iMovie and Final Cut Pro libraries. Also, any other app that uses videos a lot is probably going to use this folder. This is a local folder just on my hard drive. So putting the Videos folder here makes sense. I'm going to get a warning here because I'm removing these from iCloud Drive and putting them on the local drive. So under Movies, I've got Videos. And that's where I can store my videos. That's a great place for it. Another great place is if you have an external drive with tons of space, you might want to create a Videos folder there as well. Now, how do you get videos directly into this folder? Well, instead of importing them into the Photos app, you can bring them directly here. If it's an SD card or a camera that you're connecting directly to your Mac and you can access it in the Finder, you could drag the video files directly from the card into this folder. And then get rid of them and then import the photos into your Photos app. Or when importing into Photos, simply select only the photos and not the videos to import them in. You can also use Image Capture, which works great for the iPhone. So I'm going to run Image Capture here, and I've got my iPhone connected to this Mac. Now, if I look here, Image Capture is going to show me a list, and I'm going to sort by kind here. And I can scroll through this list. There are a lot of photos on this camera, but I can find the videos pretty easily here. I can see them. There's just a few of them and they're listed as MOV, as kind. So I can select one and I can drag and drop this into the Finder and it will pull that video out. I could also select a video and then choose to import it, and I can even select the folder. So I could decide I want to go directly into that Videos folder that I created under Movies, Videos, choose that one, and then import the one I've got selected. You can also just AirDrop the video directly from your phone to your Mac and then drag it into the Videos folder. But anyway you get your videos here, there's a lot you can do to organize these. As you can see, I like to give them good names so I can tell what each one is. You can give names that include dates or locations or anything that you want. But of course you're going to have the date modified here in the list view, so you can use that as well. You can also select a video or any file in the Finder for that matter, and you could add tags to it. So you can tag your videos to organize them. You can also add comments, and comments will show up when you do spotlight searches. Another thing you could do is you can create subfolders in here. So you can create a new folder and add your videos into that, so you can have this structure here of folders and subfolders. Now you quickly see the videos here by going into column view and selecting them, and you'll see the preview pane on the right, and you can even click and view the video. You can also, of course, select any video you want in any view you want, like list view, and hit the space bar and it will open up in Quick Look. You can use the gallery view as well, and you get a really cool way to view your videos. It's almost like you're in some sort of library management app here, because you can click through these and the videos have a little playback timeline at the bottom and a volume control. And also Mojave gives us the quick action, so you have the ability to trim and rotate videos right here in the Finder. So it really does almost feel like you're in some sort of special video library app, even though you're just viewing these files in the Finder. If you want to share a video, you've got the share button here, or you can control click on it and use share. You can of course also double click on it and it should open up by default in QuickTime Player. And from QuickTime Player you've got the ability to trim, you've got the ability to merge videos and put them one after each other. You can share from here as well in various different ways, and export as well. So whether you just have a few videos or many, you may want to consider storing those videos just as files in a folder in the Finder rather than in the Photos app or some other photo management tool. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.